morning. It's May 2nd. I haven't been, like I said, I don't sleep very good. I haven't slept good for a long time, you know. I mean, it's nice. The room's nice and everything. Sleep's good. But it's just the attitude in the nation. Even the room that I'm in, you know. Like I said, in the morning, first thing, you know, I had people coming at me. Very strange. Yesterday was a very strange day. You know what I mean? These guys, they're acting strange, you know. But anyhow, I'm sure people got to be noticing it as well. What really confused me yesterday was the guy looked at me and goes, "What are you looking at, man? How come you keep staring at me?" And I went over and I said, "Man, I'm not even looking at you until you said something to me." I said, "When you asked me for a light, that's when I looked at you and told you I didn't smoke, that I didn't have a light." And then he just started going, "I'll bless you up, man. I'll bless you up." He goes, "Man, I've got many, many different ways into the kingdom of heaven. I know a lot of different ways to the kingdom of heaven." And a little while later, I walked outside. He's out there smoking. And he asked me for a light again, you know. "Hey, man, you got a light?" And, you know, just the mentality, the way everybody's acting and stuff like that. This nation's definitely under a bad curse. It's demonic now. We got a lot of people here that are fully demonic. They've had their ears tickled for such a long time. Some of these things that I'm going to read some out of, somebody asked me to read this one too, out of 2 Timothy 3. 2 Timothy 3. It's on page 1414 in my Bible. The coming apostasy. I mean, this is exactly, I read this not too long ago. These are the things where people should be reading them. This is the things that, you know, the churches should have been reading as well. Rather than speaking about how blessed everybody is, they should have been reading these things. Because I'll tell you what, it don't feel like no blessing out here today. It feels more like it's a damned nation, is what it feels like. It is a damned nation. I can tell, I know the difference. I'm not under no illusions here. I think that's why I came here. You know, something told me to come out here. Let me tell you something, man. This is by far the worst place that I've seen. Unless it's, you know, totally, the whole nation is just totally changing into what I've been seeing. 2 Timothy 3, the coming apostasy. Coming, it is. That's, we're here now. "In the last days, perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy." You know, that's what I say in this hotel I'm in right now. These are nice rooms, and yeah, I find out the next morning I'm in here that this is all, they're letting Section 8 stay here. And it's not cheap. And I guess they're paying for their rooms too here. They are paying for their rooms. They told me they furnish them like $2,000 a month. You know, I mean, I told them, I said, "Well, all this is coming to an end. You know, it's coming to an end." I said, "All of it. The whole thing. Everything you can see, it's coming to an end. There's no way a nation could survive." And this woman had 3 kids. She couldn't even take care of them. She was on drugs. I could tell she was nodding. Her eyes were nodding. And she was pregnant, getting ready for a 4th. And smoking and, you know, everything without natural affection. Truth breakers. False accusers. in contentment, fierce, despisers of those that are good, despisers of those that are good. Let me tell you something, good people in the world today are going to be very, very hard to find. Now, can you imagine once God takes us out of the way? You know, those that have been trying to do what's right. Once we're gone, it's going to be wicked here. I think that's why I seen a lady I was talking to at the store. She was okay until something came over her, like a glaze. And she just got like a hard, stoned look, and she looked up like this out of the side of her eyes. I'm like, oh, man. Yeah, this is definitely it. Traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. From such turn away, for of this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women laden with sins, led away with divers lust, ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. That's like that guy that told me he knew many ways into the kingdom of heaven. You know, and the Bible's perfectly clear. Narrow is the path. You know, I wonder how Joel Osteen, you know, he sells so many of his books. That's why I say, when I told you to go, you know, to a Christian bookstore to get your King James Version Bible, you know, you're gonna be very surprised to see all the different books in there. The ear-tickling type of books. Joyce Myers, Joel Osteen, Sam Hagee, all of them, man. I mean, honestly, there ain't one book that should be written by any of these pastors. These are all ear-tickling books. The Word of God is the only book we should be reading. We got all the apostles that followed Jesus. These are the words. Because I could read this book over and over and over and over and over and over and keep learning something new from it. But when we start putting this down and reading the books that, you know, where these people wanted to twist the Word of God, they're twisting it, whether they realize it or not, because it's not coming out of here. Little pieces of it, and then they add a lot of their own stuff to that. And they're going to be standing before God going, yes, but Lord, I did this, you know, for you to draw the people into the church, and he's going to say, I don't know you, man, because he's going to know the mind and the heart. And it was all about the money, is what they were thinking about. Ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Now, as Janus and Jambres withstood Moses, so do these also resist the truth, men of corrupt minds, reprobate, concerning the faith, but they shall proceed no further. For their folly shall be manifest unto all men, as theirs also was. The defense of the faith. But thou hast fully known my doctrine, manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, charity, patience, persecutions, afflictions, which came unto me at Antioch, at Iconium, at Lystra. What persecutions I endured. But out of them all the Lord delivered me, yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them, and that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. All scripture is given by inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the men of God may be perfect through furnished unto all good works. Makes you wonder, how is it that they could, how could they get away from it and start teaching all these different things, you know? Before, I want to show this photo again, because we have new people coming in here all the time, and there's people that don't like to see this, so it's important that I show it, you know, because this tells me when I show it, and I hear these people that don't like to see it. I took this photo in 1977. You clearly see that little angel above my head. Right there. It's right there. There's that little angel right there. And there's the end of the trumpet right there. You see it right there. There's a little bitty clock, white horse, and the bathtub. That's why I'm always telling you, we got to keep ourselves clean. When I say clean, I mean our mind. It's what's inside our mind. We have to keep it clean constantly. I took this photo in 1977. It sat in my mother's drawer from 1977 until 2014. Nobody ever even looked at this photo. My sister Hope sent it to me when my mother passed away. My mom kept saying, you know, when I was a child, she seen an angel standing over my crib. And then throughout my whole life growing up, she kept telling me that she thought Mark, there's something special about you. And, you know, I always thought, well, that's just the way the mothers are, you know, with all their children. Every mother thinks that about their children. You know, they always have hopes for him. And, how did we fall so far away from this doctrine? I'm going to be grateful when this is finished, you know. I've seen it change. Like I said yesterday, I ain't saying it just to be saying it either. I've seen where demons literally entered people and host them. One time while I was in a restaurant, I think it was a Perkins. No, it wasn't a Perkins, but something, one of those like that. It was in Florida. Shortly after I got that photo, it's like they started, either that or else God let me see this. I don't know how it happened, but this girl kept looking for her boyfriend to come out of the bathroom. And I kept, you know, after a while, she just kept looking. She was sitting in front of me, and I was eating. And then when she kept turning to look, I thought she was looking at me at first, but then I realized she was looking for her boyfriend to come out of the bathroom. And then after a while, she kept doing it so much that I started to do it. I started to look. And then he came out of the bathroom, and when he did, I seen his whole face twitch. His whole face, like, twitched really fast. And then he got those demon-looking eyes. I've got a photo of somebody like that. I'll show it to you. It's two photos, and you can see the eyes, and you can see where they spit their tongue out really fast. That's what they did, directed it straight at me. Had I not seen that, I wouldn't have believed it. But even seeing it, and I know what they did, because I've seen it perfectly clear, directed at me, let me know. This happened again at a Walmart store. This guy stuck his head around the corner at me, like he stretched his neck really hard to look at me, and I looked at him. He did the same thing. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm not believing what I'm seeing. I've seen these demons jump in people while they're riding bicycles, homeless people riding bicycles and then waving their hands like, look, look, look. And another guy in a truck was like this right here, waving his head like, yeah, we're like, look at this. Like they're here to harvest souls, like they're here to get a lot of souls. And I'm thinking to myself, oh my gosh, I mean, maybe the Lord's letting me see this to be a witness to this. And, I've been doing this ever since. Ever since I've been doing this. It was like as if my business was destroyed. I mean, I had these people come up to me and tell me, Mark, if you speak less about this, we'll build your business up. We'll turn your business around. They didn't say about, they said if you speak less about Jesus Christ, is what they said. And if you read Revelation 3, it says, thou did not deny my name. Therefore, I will spare thee the moment of trial that's coming upon the whole world. So I know I'm going to be spared what's coming. I know that because that's God's word. It's good. Jesus Christ, man, his word is good as can be. I know that I'm going to be spared what's coming. And also, that's why you've been hearing me saying how important it is. Like when you go to work, because this has been something that's been put upon me, okay? And I know the truth, okay? This is what you need, this is what you really need to know here. You remember when they took Christ out of our schools, okay? Everybody knows this. The violence increased. And then, a year and a half later, something like that, they took it out of the government. And then soon after that, they said it, religion and politics don't belong on the job. So what happens when they said that? It don't belong on the job? But yet they're still sitting there talking about politics. See, those that aren't bringing up the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that's denying his name. And you don't even know it. And he says, those that are ashamed of me, I'll be ashamed of them. How many people do you think that there are that are afraid to sit back and say anything? Because you're not going to stand in front of the Lord and say, well, Lord, it wasn't allowed. They said it wasn't allowed. They said politics weren't allowed either, but you guys talked about your politics. Because I've had people saying that to me. Man, are you voting for Trump? He'll save us. And these are the times when, it's the end times here. And people can't recognize the what's happening because they've had their ears tickled for such a long time. We're heading, like, backwards. We're heading to the Stone Age, man, and people can't even tell the difference. We went from moving forward in Christ to going backwards now. That's exactly what's happening. It's exactly. And now, it won't be long where, people are going to think, well, they already do. They think all they got to do is believe, and they're saved. Oh, I believe in Jesus Christ. I believe he was raised from... Well, the devil believes that, too. All the angels believe that, too. The fallen angels, they all believe that. That Christ died and was raised. Matter of fact, they more than believe it. They know it, because they were witness to it. So they got even more faith than you. That's not going to get them in there, though, is it? It won't. Because they believe it. I mean, they believe it strongly. He went up on that cross for those that believe and repent from what's happening now. Having a little tea this morning. Another thing I want to say, right when I woke up this morning, I couldn't sleep, and it was exactly 1:11. 1:11. And they say one, the ones are a sign of destruction. what's getting ready to come. And I know it's getting ready to happen. You guys never heard me claim to where I say I know the day or the hour, because I don't. And when somebody says that they do, you know, I have reservations with them. I don't just have reservations. I don't believe them, you know, because it's written in there. Nobody's going to know that day and hour. Because if Jesus Christ says he doesn't even know, yet somebody's going to come say that they do. No, you know, like it says in here, you know, the coming apostasy. You know, you can't trust anybody anymore. Especially if they're tickling your ear, you know, telling you what you want to hear. Right there, you know. I know it's not that easy to see it, but you clearly see it. That little white thing right there. I mean, if you look, even my picture's faded, you know what I mean? I'm 55 years old now, and I was only 17 years old in that photo. Just 17. You know, it's crazy. You see those three geese right there? I don't show all this photo. You know, it's kind of folded up. But you can clearly see those three geese right there. Well, man, this really shocks me, because when I got here to this town here, not right here to this town, but not far from here, like within 50 to 70 miles from here, I pulled off to get gas someplace. And then as I was going back to get on the interstate, underneath that bridge, on all the walls there, there are pictures of geese like this, all underneath there. Pictures of geese on both sides of the bridge. I'm outside of Madison, Wisconsin. Now, some of you guys that are in this area, you may have also seen them, you know, driving through or passing through out here. I'm in Madison, Wisconsin now. I didn't see no bridge like that here. There is no bridge here that I've seen. But there is a town before I got here. It was full of them underneath the bridge, both sides. That's why I say sometimes this feels like deja vu to me unfolding. And this morning when I woke up, I seen that bridge, that my clock saying 111. 111. And I'm going to tell you something, man. I'm 55. This month is my birthday, May 23rd. May's the fifth month. 2 + 3 = 5. 55. You know? Everything I've been seeing, you know? And I know the Lord ordained me for this, you know? And it's like, I'm like, you know, at one time I know it's a blessing, but at the same turn, I also know, It's a highly, something you can't take lightly, you know, and, you have to make sure you get this out right. I mean, right. And I know why he's got me here doing it, because number one, I'm not proud. I'm not boastful. I'm none of those things. I've always tried to help my neighbors. My wife didn't like it. Especially when times were slow. You know, but I did it to keep myself busy and to help my neighbors, you know. I knew that they needed it. You know, if people were more like that, let me tell you this. When we get into the kingdom of heaven, that's what we're going to be doing. I promise you that. Everybody's going to. Because we ain't going to have money. It ain't going to be about money, you know. It ain't never going to be about money. You know, that's all going to be over. You know, but anyhow, I seen those geese underneath the bridge as I was passing, driving by. They're all over, looked just like that too, same color, everything. You know, some of you guys have probably driven through here in Wisconsin and seen those underneath the bridges, because they're here. If they got them underneath one bridge, I'm sure they got them under more. You've had to have seen them. I did. I've seen them underneath one town here. And I'm just getting into it. Madison, Wisconsin. You guys know, anybody that's been through here, you know it's the truth. You know it's the truth. I know you're looking at those geese and you're probably thinking the same thing. Yes, I have seen those. Yeah, and then here I am, right here. It's almost like that clock. Like time's running out. Because what drew me here, you know? What drew me here? Something drew me here. You know, I felt compelled. Why was I compelled to come here? I went around the whole nation. And that's what I've done. I've reported everything. Everything that I've seen around this whole nation. And I told you how everybody acts exactly the same. And I've told you also, there's this guy, it's called the Grotex, one, Grotx one, the, you gotta put THE in front of it, the Grotex one, the number one, just, you know, anyhow, he's the one that, pointed things out that, you know, things that I knew, but I learned more from what I've seen on his show. I knew that there was demons hosting people, but what I didn't know was, what I do know now, is there's this demon, it looks like a clown. That's why you're seeing people with red and purple hair everywhere doing the same thing. The exact same thing. They talk the same, everything they do. Piercing their lips, their nose, megatons in their ears, piercing through their face and all that. People are doing the exact same thing because that one demon clown can host millions of people at the same time. At the same time. That's why you hear them mimicking each other because they say the same thing. And they don't even know it. It's a spirit that comes in them and they're all doing the same thing. Including politicians, man. They're all, you wouldn't think that this was possible, but it is. When you walk out the front door and people would look up into the space and go, I wonder if there's life on other planets. What we should have been wondering is how many spirits there were over the period of billions of years. How many spirits there were, not life. Not life like we know it. Because our life is short. It's the blink of an eye. We should have been wondering how many spirits there are out there. Well, let me tell you something. A lot of them are being held back right now. And that's when the evil's going to engulf this place. I had a vision of a... wasn't much of one either. It was just pure darkness. I mean, pure darkness, man. Black. I couldn't even see in it. You know, that's what I didn't like about this dream. I couldn't even wake up from it. And it was like all the animals were freaking out, man. Like as if something, danger, danger. That's what it was. All the animals were freaking out. I didn't hear people talking to me or nothing. It was just the animals freaking out. And can you imagine hearing animals being afraid, like a fire or something was burning around them and they had to get away from it? You know, birds, everything you can think of, all the animals. And I couldn't wake up from it. And then when I did wake up, I was like, what the heck? You know, I knew it was danger. I knew it was. You know, just like those ducks right here, these geese. I seen them underneath the bridge. Underneath the bridge here. I had no idea they had these geese like this. All underneath the bridge. Now, some of you people that are watching this, I know you, if you've been through this state, you've seen them. You've seen them underneath the bridge. Then you see, that's me underneath of them. With the angel blowing the trumpet. Okay? What do you think I've been doing? I've been trying to warn people for a long time. And I'm going to tell you something. I've gotten a little bit of help these past month and a half. Somebody paid for this whole room here for a week. They sent me the money to do it. And I told them I was going to get a room for a whole week because I haven't done this in years. I lived in my shop for 2 years, and it wasn't nothing like this. This is nice. I didn't even have a shower in my shop. Most people wouldn't have done what I did. They would never have done what I've done. They would have rented something else. I was trying to keep my business alive. You know, I wasn't planning on doing what I'm doing. God had all this stuff planned. You know, because I didn't quite understand what was going on at that time. You know, but now, it's like, see that bridge I came over and I seen all those geese. That bridge that I came under just before I got here. And I seen all those geese, man. It's like, it's as if all this is unwinding. You know, like a clock. You know, like a clock. Unwinding. Look at this. See, there's that white horse. There's that clock right there. A little clock. Okay? You can perfectly see it. It's like the time's running out. It's running out. I mean, I've been doing this for quite a while now. Going on 3 years, probably. Just, I mean, heavy since I've had that photo. I got that photo in the beginning of 2014. And I was doing it before that, actually. All my jobs I was going to tell them, because I knew something was wrong. All my customers, the people I was bidding jobs, people would say, how come you're so much more expensive? I said, I'm not. I said, the prep alone, because I did stucco repair, plaster repair, drywall repair, and I told them it's going to take me 2-3 days just to get it ready to paint. Some of them took me up to 4 days, depending on how bad the stucco was on the outside of a house. And then I would spend $400 on material plus another $600 to $800 on labor just to get it ready to paint. And other people would have it painted faster than I could have it ready. Because they didn't do no prep. And I was explaining to people that nobody was doing it right. Because a lot of times I'd be tapping on the stucco and the stucco would fall off. Because nobody was doing it right. The air conditioning from the inside of the house and the humidity from the outside is causing condensation. Where the crack in the block. I got photos of it. If anybody wants to see it, I'll send it to you, man. Unreal, man. I woke up at 1:11 a little bit ago. 1:11. It's 2:05 now. Barely been awake. Almost an hour. 1:11 I woke up. And then here I am. I'm pointing out those geese. That, you know, this is almost like a clock running out of time. We don't have much time. I know we don't. I know we don't have much time. I can't see like I used to. I'll be glad when this is over. You know? Look at it. 33:33. Alright, I better let this go because this is getting into a long videotape. God bless you, man. Know this, I'm not here to tickle your ear. I'm just telling you the truth on everything. Like I said, I seen a new change in people when I got here. The first morning, this is going to be my second morning going out here for breakfast this morning. You know, I got approached right away. You know, people were like, what are you looking at? You know, that mentality. And I told him, I'm not even looking at you, man. The only time I looked at him was when he asked me for a light. Then he asked me for another light when I walked outside. He didn't even remember talking to me. You know, and then everybody I shared with, man, it's like a whole new, we've stepped it up to another level. Time's running out, okay? This is more important than you guys even know. That's why I've been telling you, man, you're hanging on to things in this world. You're hanging on to them. And this is all soon going to be over with. And the Bible clearly says, what are these things going to be worth when it comes to your soul? What could you trade for it? Nothing. as nothing, because this stuff's going to be destroyed here quickly. And I also read a passage out of there. God said, you know, he doesn't care how bad or whatever you did in the past. If you stop right now and you repent of it right now, it'll never be remembered again. It'll be forgotten in the sea of forgetfulness. In other words, you move forward. I've had people sitting there saying, man, I'm praying and I'm found worthy, man. I feel, you know, for the things that they've done in their past. Well, let me tell you something. Once you've done that, and once you've repented, and you're not doing it no more, then let it go. Stop, because he's not going to remember it. Why should, what, don't beat yourself up over it. Just move forward. And then, you know, you're a new person. And then just keep staying in the Word, reading. We don't have much longer, and we're going to be out of here. That's why he says to come out of it. He doesn't want to condemn nobody. Nobody. You know? You've got to forget what you did in your past. Just move on. But you got to remember, it says it's hard for a rich man to make it because they don't want to let go of anything. You know? Maybe you can do something that can open some eyes. You know? I don't know. Help some people out or something, you know? You'd be surprised how many eyes that would open up and make them think that something is going on, you know? You'd be surprised what you can do in these final moments, you know? But you got to come out of yourself first. And when you do that, you just move forward, man. Get ready. Not only that, you're going to see things like I've been seeing them, you know? And the spiritual attacks, you get those too, man. But we get strong from them, you know. That's where my mom always used to tell me that. You know, Mark, when you were little, you always used to say, when the tough get going, or when things get going gets tough, the tough get going. I'm saying, I don't remember saying that at all. But she kept telling me that as if, you know, what I'm going through today. You know? I don't remember ever saying that. But, you know, that's the truth. That's where we're at today. Remember what I said about those geese? Have you ever seen those underneath bridges here? You know, I've never seen them until I got here. And then I got them right there in that photo. You know, my mom hung them on the wall there. It's as if time's running out. And I can see it in the attitude of people, too. That being said, God bless you, man. I pray that you find, you know, be with the Holy Spirit. And don't deny the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. You got to be seeing a change in everything, you know. Remember what I said, people that they go to work, they talk about their politicians. Don't be ashamed to mention Jesus Christ's name, because it says in there, he'll be ashamed of you as well, you know. I know I've never denied his name. I've had people offer me lots of money to go to work for him, and I could have easily been living very well, but my knowledge of the Lord is stronger than anything in this world. God bless you, man.